Do you like bread? I'm crazy about it. Today we see its history, its pros and its cons, its nutritional properties, and above all, I will also give you my own personal recipe. Hello, I'm Pasquale and I'm your nutritional lifestyle coach. And today I'll talk you about one of the most popular foods in the world, the bread. A product made from simple ingredients such as water, flour, yeast and salt, but it produces a complex product in these nutritional values and the chemical and biological reaction involved, and which depend on a product that is great in smells and flavors and is appreciated by everybody. I will also give you in the description of the video a link of the Stefano Vendrame, another one of my gurus here on YouTube. Indeed, as you say, my first guru, because at the time when I was diagnosed my disease, I decided to undertake the nutrition courses immediately after discovering my disease, and thanks to the passion that Stefano was putting in this topic in the video, I appreciate these studies. So if you speak Italian, I recommend you to look at the above video and even subscribe to its channel. Now let's start with my video. I want to also remind you that after I will bore you, as I always do, with the pure nutritional data, but I think these boring talks are the most useful ones. At the end of the video, I will also give you my own personal recipe, so follow me up to the end of this video. So, bread is one of those foods that existed since the beginning of time. Primitive men were also accustomed to preparing a simple version of the modern bread. In fact, they used to grind the grains of wheat between two stones and then mix the powder obtained with water and then bake it on fire. We can call it bread 1.0 if we want to use a modern terminology. It is, however, during the Egyptian era that bread begins to take the form and the methodologies known today. In fact, some historical sources argue that the first experiments in leavening were initiated by the Egyptians. Later, during the Greek period and then during the Roman Empire, bread begins to be also flavored and with herbs and seasonings. For example, the milk bread was invented by the Greeks. It is quite common to eat it in Calabria, which is the area where I come from. During the Renaissance era, the use of brewery yeast was introduced. History or legend narrates that a female servant made absently fall some beer into a dough, but she said nothing as she feared to be punished. The bread that came out from this dough was much softer and more aromatic. I honestly don't know if it is a true story, I haven't examined it in depth. If you know more about it, please leave a comment for me in the section below. The bread goes through simple operation steps and we'll see it together now. The first is the dough, where we'll mix all the ingredients together. Second one is the fermentation, where the dough is left to rest. Third is the shaping and the panning, in which the loaves are formed to be used in the various forms of bread. Then the leavening, in which bacteria consume the sugar in the compound and the mix together and develop carbon dioxide and doubling or tripling the volume of the dough. Finally, the cooking, in which the product is finally transformed into something edible. The choice of the type of flour to be using is strictly linked by personal taste, unless you are looking for gluten-free flour because you are suffering from celiac disease. There is wheat, rye, spelt, rice or cornmeal, and you can even mix all together. The important thing is that you use only whole grain flours. And yes, because it's the key of the whole discussion here. The white flour have been catastrophic in nutritional terms because for purely commercial reason, they've denaturated a product that was so good in nutrition, transforming into a nutritionally bad product. To understand what we are talking about, we must consider the grain or wheat. That is formed by several layers, you can see here in the image. We have the outer shell, which is the outermost part of the grain. Then the bran, which contains group B vitamins, minerals, phytocompounds, insoluble fiber and proteins. Then we have the germ, which contains lipids such as omega-3 and precursor of the vitamin A, beta-carotene. Finally, we have the endosperm, which is mainly contains sugar in the form of starch. The methods of modern grinding makes remaining within the flour only and exclusively the endosperm. So eating bread today basically means, as Stefano Vendrame say, to take a sugar bowl and eat a spoonful of it. Nothing more and nothing less than that. Our bread today on our table is simply sugar. The motivation of this processing technique is, as I said before, purely commercial. In fact, the germ contains lipids and tend to rancid during long period of storage, like any other oil does. So the white fiber lacking of this element is conserved instead for a much longer period of time, giving the strong advantage to the food industry. This is why we nutritionists recommend you only and exclusively whole meal flour. Now I will show you some reports to compare the two flours, white and whole meal, just comparing the two types of bread, the white bread and the whole grain bread. Let's start with calories first. As you can see, whole meal bread is less caloric. This is because having more fibers, if we have two same pieces of bread of the same weight, the whole grain bread will have a lower carbohydrate intake. Now let's see the vitamins report. As you can see, also here there is no absolutely match between the two of those. Most of the group B vitamins, vitamin E and beta carotene, disappear almost completely from the nutritional sources if we compare the whole meal bread with the white bread. Needless to say, that is absolutely not good. For minerals, you can see how iron, iodine and zinc are halved, while phosphorus is reduced by one third, and also potassium is almost a third of the value present in the wholemeal bread. Now that I bore you with enough data, why don't we see how to prepare a good tasty recipe made with the whole grain flour? Follow me in these simple steps. Thanks everybody, I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm trying to, from time to time, to improve the format and to make it less boring and increasingly educational. And most of all, I hope I convince you to abandon the shy that is white bread and take only whole grain bread from now on. Please leave me a comment and advices in the appropriate section below. Help me to improve the contents. Let me also know how the bread came out with my recipe. I'm very interested in that. I also recommend you to follow me on the social networks such as Facebook and Instagram, and on my website www.healthmefood.com. Subscribe to the channel and click the bell notification to receive new alerts of the new videos. Also, please share and like this video and help me to spread my message to a wider audience. Well, what else left? I'm only left to say, eat well, live well and smile, and see you next time. Ciao!